does your body language speak louder than words? What are you unintentionally revealing through your gestures and posture? I'm feeling a lot of pressure by how I'm speaking and sitting and what I'm doing. Body language experts claim that our non-verbal communication reflects what's really going on in our subconscious mind, and that once we've mastered the art of reading the signs, we are all open books. Dr. Louise Mahler is an internationally recognised body language expert, and she joins us this morning. Thank you so much for joining us. Is there any science behind body language?
Yes, of course there is. I mean, most body language has been studied in non-verbal studies, and they use scientific methodology. I mean, what happens is it all goes awry. So, for instance, they look at, are you lying? And some research shows 30 times a day, some shows 10 times a day, some shows once every 2 days, some show men lie more than women, then the next week it's women lie more than men. You know, the issue is, who are they researching? You know, what is their basis? And that area is a problem. But there are other areas which they can look at, like voice and the amount of air that comes out of your body for voice. So vocal fry, when we do vocal fry, it vocal fry sounds vocal like fry. That.
That's when you're sort of crackling a little bit.
Yeah, and vocal fry. What happens when you do vocal fry is they've measured it and it's 1/6 of the airflow actually comes out of your body. So you're not touching people, you're not caressing people with your sound.
Well, so people are trying to figure out what we're saying. They're all looking at the wrong things.
Yes, 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 yes. Wow. So perception, what we do in Australia with perception is we say, oh, the study of perception is a problem, therefore we just reject it. And we go, oh, mate, I just bring who I am, you know? I'm not pandering to perception. I just bring who I am.
It's not bad.
Yes. Yeah, it's quite good. Sound a bit
well,
like
you know something with body language, because they say if you fold your arms, that's a bad. But quite often I find it comfortable to just sit with my arms folded. So I think, is that a misleading to say that's being rude when perhaps it's been comfortable?
Yeah, it is comfortable, but why is it comfortable? It's comfortable because it's a defence mechanism. So when you actually fold your arms, what you're doing is you're defending yourself and you're holding your diaphragm, you're holding your breath. And so what's happening is you feel protected and it's a cuddle. So self-cuddle, you know, what a great thing to do.
I'm happy to self-cuddle.
Do people freeze when they see you? Because I'm terrified to move.
And I know, that's
brilliant. I'm brilliant. You something about me that I'm not sure I want you to know. So what is the connection between the mind and the body?
Oh, total connection. Total connection. Mind actually governs body. You know, so what happens, for instance, is when we get defensive, you know, it's very Louise Hay, which parts of the body jam? And so this is what Pauline Hanson does. When she gets defensive, what she does is she jams the back of her neck. Jams the back of her neck. So when we get defensive, it's as though you're backed up against a wall, you know? So you start turning your whole body. The throat goes tight. And you can't breathe. So this says defensiveness. The mind is defensive. The body goes defensive. And, you know, you get a certain sound. So the voice is a thermometer of what's happening in the body, and the body is a thermometer of what's happening in the mind.
And the whole time that you're talking, I'm hardly even listening to you because I'm just watching everything you do, and you're moving your hands so deliberately. And I know that politicians are told to move their hands very deliberately. And one who very famously does it, in fact, his hands have become the subject of national debate, is Donald Trump.
We do.
China. Can you take us through a few of his signature sort of hand moves and what they mean?
Well, what they say is psychopaths gesture more than other people.
Don't hold back.
Psychopaths or sociopaths?
Well, psychopaths are born, sociopaths are moulded. So, you know, sociopath, possibly.
Can't just be Italian?
Well, no. You see, Italians will repeat gestures, but psychopaths will do congruent gesturing. So they know where the hands are going. So what does Trump do? He actually, you're looking very worried.
Yeah.
He actually...
Because you're moving your hands so well, I think you might be a psychopath.
Well, you know, I think we should all develop the skills of sociopathy and understand these skills. So what Trump does is, he keeps his palms out at all times. What does this say? It says trust. You see, I have no pennies between my fingers. I have no tricks, nothing to hide. So he does that. Absolutely deliberate. He can spend 5 minutes like this. And then he has good on his right, he has bad on his left. He often puts bad down. You know, it was all Hillary was bad, he was good and it was up here.
The with his hands?
Out there. Yeah, yeah. It's very deliberate. Now, what he has to do is he has to have a resting position but keep the hands out. Well, you can't close them in any way. He never clenches his fists. So he does the L sign. to make a full stop, or he does the, which is a success sign.
Yeah.
You know, this is very clever. He never crosses his body. Ever. So most of us, you know, you say crossing your arms is defensiveness. Well, he never does.
He never does.
You watch. He never crosses his body. So it's all completely revealed, nothing to hide. There's good, there's bad. Very hypnotic.
So his body language is actually quite clever.
Hypnotism was how he won the election.
And what about our leaders? What about Malcolm Turnbull?
Yeah, so Malcolm Turnbull, if you watched him a few years ago, he had a lot of unconscious competence. So what he'd do is he'd do a very advanced skill with his hands, and he would gesture one hand here and then he'd gesture with the other hand. But we put so much stress on our leaders that what happens is they get under so much stress, and I can pinpoint the time at which Malcolm Turnbull got frightened. It was during the debate. The arms jam onto the body. And when that happens, most people you'll see start to do Tyrannosaurus Rex. So they talk like a Tyrannosaurus and they do this, or, you know, something like that. But what he started to do was the karate chop. The symmetric karate chop. And the thing with gestures is they have to be congruent and they cannot be repeat. They become meaningless after two repeats. So this is a meaningless gesture. Then if he wants to become powerful, he clenches his fists. Now, if you've ever learnt piano, you know the power does not come from the elbow down. Power comes from the whole body. So this is not powerful. Wow. It's just closed.
Right. It's gone from unconscious confidence to conscious
absolutely.
Lack of confidence.
You'd have a big night at it on the dance floor at a nightclub, I tell you, reading all the signs from people. What about Melania Trump? Because I look at Melania and I worry, I think, is she as happy as we want her to be? She looks a bit withdrawn and a bit sad.
And you can tell that.
Melania has, you know, what Ida has, a beautiful rest position, what you all have, a beautiful rest position and neutrality. And she has that, and she holds that basically all day until he tries to touch her, and then she's back. And then she's back again.
What about us here on the panel? Can you read, I mean, I don't even know what I'm doing now, I'm self-conscious. Can you read me or others? What do,
well,
what
Joe, what you've got is you've got the biggest mouth I've ever seen. and you've got huge teeth. You've got massive teeth. And what that says is it's all about trust, because teeth are, you know, in ancient times, we gnawed with the teeth. And you've got those teeth. So by presenting them with your big mouth, you're saying, go ahead, hit me. You know, I'm just teeth. I'm perfect. And then what you do is with that mouth, you don't close it. So you talk, but you never actually close it. So it actually stays open at all times, you know, which is all about trust me, trust me. Then your repeat gesture, you actually do that. That's your major gesture. And when you make a conclusion, you go, oh, this is right. You look down and you stand on the table. You go, so I think what's critical, and then you come back to that. But the mouth is open, the teeth are bared, nothing to hide, complete trust.
Right.
There
we go. Did you spend the morning with Joe's wife?
You know, Hillary Clinton does this. So Hillary Clinton will walk on stage, she'll put her hands in the air like this, and she'll open her mouth. I once timed it for 5 minutes. She just walked around going, and she can even talk. She can go, thank you, thank you. And then now the shot. It's honesty, openness. It's so important. So, Lamo, it's over. You know, it's over. This is over.
Now, when you talk,
you might feel comfortable. No, not good for you.
Arms are back here now.
To you all morning, but we've run out of time. I am so sorry. Aren't you fabulous? Yeah. Please thank Dr. Louise Mahler.